And joining us on Hot Copy, Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAAP Deputy Director General John Andrews is with us, and Cebu Pacific Vice President for Marketing and Distribution and Spokesperson Candice Iyog is with us. Good morning, Captain Andrews and Candice. Good morning to you. All right, now first, what is taking Cebu Pacific, honestly, in simple language, so long to actually move the aircraft out of the runway?
Yes, actually, Karen, we're doing the best we can to remove the aircraft from the runway. And in fact, we have, aside from the Cebu Pacific team, we have from Singapore Engineering Company, who's there also. Mm-hmm. They're specialists in this kind of an operation, and they're helping us remove the aircraft, except that the weather conditions are also not helping. It's very muddy, so they're having a hard time lifting the aircraft.
So you have to lift the aircraft off. Is it true that I heard one of the reasons is it's because Cebu Pacific prefers that the aircraft be saved, that it's whole?
I don't know about that. It's the first time I'm hearing of that statement, so mm-hmm. I can't really say whether it's true or not.
Okay. All right. Now, your comment, Captain Andrews, on Cebu Pacific not clearing the aircraft just yet.
Well, the law says that once an accident happens, the incident is not supposed to be touched until the aircraft investigation team gets to the scene.
Have they gotten there?
They got there together with the Cebu Pacific people the following day at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, after the initial investigation, that is when Cebu Pacific took over the clearing of the aircraft. They asked for an initial time of about 8 o'clock in the evening to clear the aircraft, which evidently did not materialize. Extension was asked for 7 o'clock this morning, which again did not happen. And as of about 3 o'clock this morning, I got a call that the Cebu Pacific team had abandoned the site, and CAAP was now taking over the clearing operation.
So you are now clearing right now as we speak?
Yes, that is supposed to be done. We have given now a possible opening of the airport at 10 o'clock this morning.
Really? Now, what about the Singapore company that Cebu Pacific hired? Will they be working with you?
I'm not aware of the exact happenings there right now.
Okay.
But we are taking charge of the clearing operations, whether the Singapore people are there or not.
Okay. All right. Let's go back to the shot of the plane. Captain Andrews, can you explain, and Candice, exactly how do you remove the plane and which part of where should it move to? Can we go back to the live feed in Davao, please? That's the live feed in Davao. All right, Captain Andrews, how do you move the plane?
The aircraft can be moved by moving it forward or putting it from the tail.
Okay, do you move it to the where there's grass, just like that?
That's going to go deeper and deeper. We need the heavy equipment to tow that aircraft, which may cause some damage to the aircraft.
Okay.
That's why Cebu Pacific has not released the retrieval operations to CAAP.
Okay, you have not released it, Candice, so your reaction?
I wouldn't be in a position to comment on that one, Karen. I think in terms of the removal of the aircraft on the ground, what we have right now are the experts who are working on the ground to remove it as quickly as possible. Now, I wouldn't be in a position to say whether it's best to move it forward or backward. You know, that's mm-hmm. not something.
So, dapat ang tanong dyan, Captain Andrews, who's in charge of a situation like this? I mean, Cebu Pacific is a private company, but clearly CAAP oversees all the airlines, all the airports. Who has the say? If Cebu Pacific refuses to turn over the removal, paano yan?
Unfortunately, there is a law that says that you must have the consent of the owner.
Really?
To move the aircraft.
Oh.
Until this law is repealed, removed, we will not have the right to remove the aircraft.
Do you have the consent?
As I heard this morning, evidently the consent has not been given.
Okay. So now let's go back. No, I mean, of course, there will be investigations done, but you had the CEO, Lance Gokongwei, saying, I don't know if he did say it, but he went live on ANC last night by phone. Do you believe it's a pilot error that occurred? I mean, I'll ask Candice.
Yeah, I think right now we have not yet seen the reports from CAAP, so we can't speculate. It's too early for us to say what caused the incident.
Okay.
So no.
Mm-mm.
As far as CAAP is concerned, the evidence does not lie.
Okay.
We have now the evidence to state for a fact that it was pilot error involved.
So it's not the plane? There was no problem with the plane?
No problem with the plane. Can we begin with the flight as it happened?
Yes, please.
The flight came in on runway 23 or Davao. It was doing a VOR DME approach.
Yeah, can you say that in layman's terms?
Well, they're going to be landing on runway 23.
Okay.
And the VOR DME approach is the instrument landing approach for that runway.
Mm.
There was an aircraft ahead of them, another Cebu Pacific aircraft, turboprop, that landed 2 minutes ahead of them.
And it was
without
fine.
Incident.
Okay.
Now, at 5 miles out, and they were approximately about 1,000 feet, the pilot declared runway in sight. That is when the tower gave them clearance to land.
Runway in sight, okay. It gave them clearance to land. Okay.
The next interchange of communication between the tower and the flight crew was the flight was asking for assistance as they were off the runway.
Okay, on air, while they were
were already on the ground.
No, on the ground, okay.
Yes, yes.
All right, and then go on.
Now, I would like to show you pictures of where the aircraft actually first touched down.
Okay. Can I hold it for you so that, okay, go ahead. Wow, this is good. You have it in graphics.
Now, this is the touchdown point of the aircraft. This is already in the shoulder of the runway. They were away from the runway.
Yeah.
The main runway is towards the left.
Ah, this is not the runway.
No, that is the shoulder of the runway.
Yeah, the runway, can you point where they should have landed?
Right here on the left.
Dito dapat.
Malayo pa.
Ah, okay.
Now the runway width is about 40 meters. This is approximately 10 meters. Now they landed, touchdown, the right wheel touchdown, very, very close to the edge of the grass portion.
Yeah.
So it only traveled a few hundred meters before it hit the grassy portion. That is why passengers said they felt a strong vibration.
Okay.
Now, during all this time, the captain had the engines on full reverse. That's why a lot of debris was thrown towards the runway.
What do you mean by having the engine in full reverse?
That is used to stop the aircraft.
To stop. It's like a brake. Okay.
It's like a brake. Instead of the thrust going out, it goes forward.
Okay.
So I will assume that both engines were damaged because of this.
Of the captain's decision.
To keep the thrust reversers on because the aircraft stopped with the thrust reversers still on the deployed position, which is, again, not practice.
Okay.
Not according to procedures.
Next.
Now we'll see.
Oh, there. Can we talk about this one? This part, the one with the graphics, there.
Yes.
There. These furrowed by right gear.
Yes. As soon as they left the main runway, on the grassy portion that was soft, the airplane was already in trouble. It continued on for about another 1,000 meters.
So the aircraft was running on the grassy portion.
On the grassy portion.
Okay, that's why
the whole time, and then it ended up there.
Okay,
that's about 1,000 meters from the end of runway 23. Total length of the runway is about 3,000 meters.
Okay,
now I'm saying that this is conclusive evidence. Which will again be substantiated by the findings of the FDR, Flight Data Recorder, which we are going to be asked to be sent to Singapore for their data.
Mm-mm.
It will show the exact position of the aircraft. And I will now make a statement based on my professional career that this was definitely pilot error caused.
Mm-mm. Okay, all right. So you have the head of CAAP, Candice, saying he is definite that it's caused by pilot error, which in a way it would show that at least your plane was in perfect condition.
Yeah.
There was nothing wrong with the engine. But it does bring to light now the qualifications and the skills of the people that Cebu Pacific hire. Can you give me a profile of the pilot?
Actually, first of all, Karen, I'd like to clarify. All of these things that Captain Andrews is showing is new to us. Now, that has not been shared with us. So we are still waiting for the full CAAP report to know whether it, we have to see the report before we can conclude even if it was indeed pilot error. But again, now in terms of the qualifications of the our pilots, in fact, Captain Andrews had said earlier in the earlier interview that they are experienced. They are mm-hmm. veteran. The number mm-hmm. of hours that they have flown is considered already as veteran. So their experience. I mean, okay. he would have the records of the
to
pilots.
Show it. Okay. Yes. Now I'll move on from the, of course, the experience of the pilot to the alleged ineptness of the Cebu Pacific crew. I'm quoting right now, actually, from the Philippine Daily Inquirer. In a specific statement by Joel Tabora, who called the Cebu Pacific crew insensitive and inept and didn't know what to do during the time of emergency. Now, I've flown on Cebu Pacific many times, and the thing I've noticed is they're all young. Mm-hmm. So do you your comment on that?
Actually, we spoke to the crew yesterday mm-hmm. and when they got back, and they narrated what had happened. And actually, after the aircraft veered off the runway and they were on the grassy area, they assessed the situation outside.
Okay.
All right. And they didn't see any imminent danger. In short, they didn't see that the engine was not on fire.
Okay.
All right.
Which was somebody had said earlier that before landing, I think
that's right.
Yeah, it
that's
was on
right.
fire. That is
so
not true.
The engine was not on fire.
Was it on fire?
We do not know if the engine okay. was on fire, but definitely the engine was hot and it was raining. There may have been steam generated.
Steam. Okay.
Yes, yes. So mm-hmm. the engine was not on fire and it was raining heavily,
yeah.
right? And it was dark. So after it had landed, and the pilot did address the cabin and said that everything's under control. All right. That was, I think, within 5 minutes from the time it landed.
Mm-hmm.
The crew had... They did not panic, actually. So they had the presence of mind to follow procedure, which is what they were trained to do. They mm-hmm. checked outside. They saw that the engine was not on fire. There was no need to immediately evacuate, or there was no need to do an emergency mm-hmm. evacuation.
Like what we know is like open the doors and suddenly
everybody
the stairs go down.
Yeah. Sliding.
Okay.
And, you know, so, and given the position of the aircraft, mm-hmm. right?
It was tilted.
It was tilted to the front. If they had opened the back and did all the slides, it could have caused more injury
mm-hmm.
if we had done, mm-hmm. If the crew had panicked and rushed everybody off the aircraft, no. So what they actually did was a precautionary disembarkation,
mm-hmm.
meaning
okay.
they had disembarked them because it in the front. It just basically means they had to disembark them, and they used the slide as a precautionary measure, given the condition and the situation and the condition of the aircraft and the position.
Mm-mm.
So. And that's why they didn't.
So you know, they walked out of the plane.
They walked and then
out.
They
okay.
slid. They amazingly slid.
Yeah. Okay.
They deployed the forward slide.
Only the forward
only,
slide.
Only right. the forward slide.
Okay.
All right. And then so after they all got off the aircraft, the crew had stayed behind, even before they allowed the passengers to slide, they also had to check each and every one and remind them that they had to have no sharp objects on their
mm-hmm,
body.
Mm-mm.
They checked them for injuries. You know,
okay.
they did all of that.
Okay.
And then after all the passengers had disembarked and they counted, they still went back and checked every row to make sure that there were no left behind passengers, that nobody was pinned down.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they had
mm-hmm.
to do all of that
okay.
before they left the aircraft,
okay.
which really shows that there really was no imminent danger. And they had actually stayed behind.
Okay. All right. On the line is Bing Harris. He is a 42-year-old businesswoman who was a passenger at that specific Cebu Pacific plane. Good morning, Bing. Thank you for taking our call.
Good morning.
Okay. How are you?
I'm fine.
All right.
Still on the trauma.
Okay. Now, refresh your memory. When did you first feel and know that something was wrong?
I feel it when we fell when the pilot announced that prepare for landing. That's the time we encounter a very bad turbulence.
You mean?
So that's turbulence. That's
okay,
the time
okay.
that I feel it's something wrong.
Okay, and then?
After on that, when we round on the Samal Island, it's really bad turbulence we encounter. And then we feel that the aircraft is very fast. on that time.
Were you were people screaming or panicking?
No, we just, my friend and I, we just holding our hands just to feel what's going on for the because I always travel, I always ride on the plane, but that time I can feel something wrong with the with the turbulence. What's that? Because it's just only an air turbulence. It's not, it's different. That time I can feel it's different.
Okay.
It's different the feeling.
Okay, kumbaga itong turbulence na naramdaman mo, sabi mo iba. Now Bing, when it landed, what happened? Of course you were not on the runway, but how did that feel inside the plane?
I tell on that time, only one word I tell. I tell my friend, I think we're gonna die, because I really feel that the plane is just like blown up when it stops down.
Okay. All right. And then after that, what, when the plane had already landed, it was no longer moving or running, what did the Cebu Pacific crew do? Were you satisfied with how the pilot and the Cebu Pacific crew handled the situation?
No, I'm never satisfied.
Okay.
I'm never satisfied how they handled the situation.
Why? What did they do?
Because when the plane stopped, the crew and the pilot never even announced to the emergency for emergency landing. We stuck up in the plane. The plane already smells smoke.
I see. So wait, if I'm hearing this correctly, when the plane was landing in a way you felt was different, you were saying the pilot should have announced brace for emergency landing. He did not.
Yes. He should do that.
Okay, Bing, 1 second. I won't ask Candice because she's not a pilot, but you are Captain Andrews. Should the pilot have announced, brace everyone, get ready, we are going on emergency landing?
No, he was not on emergency landing. He was trying to land the plane normally.
Okay, all right. So Bing, you heard that. In other words, he was not on emergency landing mode. He was trying to land the plane normally. Okay, now when the plane had already landed, the crew itself, what happened? What did the crew do?
Because I'm sitting on the first row, I can see the crew. They are just panicking.
The crew is panicking. In what way?
Yes. They never even do the announcement. What's going on? The people is screaming already.
Okay. All right. 1 second, Bing. I'm not an expert. Let me ask both Candice and Captain. Ideally, Bing, I hope you're watching ANC. The planes landed, I mean, turbulence over. What's the first thing that the crew and the pilot should have done? Any of you?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Normal emergency procedures dictate that an evacuation should be declared and done immediately.
By mic. Because yes, there's a mic on the plane.
The captain will announce evacuate. And the cabin attendants will open the doors. If the airplane was in this position, they will only open the front doors and the slides will be deployed.
Okay.
And passengers are to the plane.
Immediately, the captain should do that?
Immediately, because this is an accident.
Okay.
Now, they will check either side, if there is fire. If there is fire on the right side, they will not deploy that chute. They will only deploy the one where there is no fire.
Okay. All right. Bing, did they do that?
It takes us, I think, more than five minutes. Screaming inside the plane before they open the door, before they decide.
Okay, Bing, is that normal? I mean, 5 minutes may not seem too long for a regular 5 minute situation, but of course, in a situation like that, 5 minutes can feel forever. Time is relative. Is that the SOP?
Regulations say that once an emergency evacuation is declared, all passengers must be evacuated in 3 minutes.
In 3 minutes? No, but she said that they declared an emergency evacuation after more or less a little longer than 5 minutes.
That's not normal.
That's not. Okay. Candice, do you want to react?
Yeah. Based on the reports that we got from the crew, was that it wasn't, they didn't declare an emergency evacuation.
Right away.
Yes. It wasn't a declared emergency evacuation.
Okay.
And that's why they didn't immediately deploy and start having people sliding.
Should they have that option? I mean, do airlines have that option?
Not that I know of.
Not that you. So, ideally, when a plane does a landing that is different from the norm,
No, because it's an emergency. The aircraft was not in a normal situation.
Yeah, it was not on the runway.
It was not on the runway. The nose gear had collapsed.
Okay, and it was already tilted towards the grass.
It was already tilted, and an evacuation should have been started.
Right away.
Because no one knows if a fire is going to emanate, come out. There is no guarantee of this. We were lucky it was raining. Maybe that prevented any fire from happening. This is a very lucky incident and nobody was hurt.
Okay. All right. Being so, I know you're hearing both Cebu Pacific and Captain Andrews. Very quickly after that, what happened? So you were evacuated?
Sorry?
You were evacuated after. How did they do it?
When we do the emergency evacuate, we just, I think we're standing up there for 3 minutes in the runway because there's no car yet arrived. It's just a fire truck there. Yes.
Okay, so wait. Now that's CAAP's problem, no? That's the airport. They were already standing outside in the runway, nababana.
Yes.
Should have they just walked or?
The emergency vehicles were already there. The firecraft people were already there.
Fire truck lang daw nandun.
Yes, because we do not provide
cars.
Transportation to enter a runway proper. This is a restricted area.
Mm-mm.
That is exactly the reason why. The 911 call made by the security guard.
Mm.
These 911 people were not allowed to enter.
What do you mean 911? It's not 911 in the Philippines.
911 is in Davao.
Okay, all right. Yeah. Okay, 911 pala sa Davao.
911. They were not allowed to enter because they had not been trained how to assist in an evacuation of an aircraft. That is the reason. I can understand the frustrations of...
the passengers.
Not only the passengers, but Mayor Duterte.
Yeah.
But this is the reason because protocols dictates this.
I see.
Now what we have to enter is the MOA with the local government, train their people. So if a similar accident happens, we have the capabilities to use their services.
Okay. Well, we're moving forward with this discussion. So what you are saying technically, when all the passengers are down on the runway, which Cebu Pacific did, talagang bawal ang CAAP and the airport magpapasok ng sasakyan.
If they are not trained, they're not qualified.
And no one in Davao is trained?
No, there are, of course, our people are trained.
Okay.
But we do not have the vehicles to do this.
I see. Okay. So ideally, Bing, anong nangyari? Naglakad kayo? Tumakbo kayo? I'm curious what happened.
Nung pagbaba namin, nakatabi na lang kami. Medyo malayo sa plane. Kasi ang inisip namin lahat noong first batch na bumaba, baka mag-blow up yung plane.
Okay.
Tamaan kami. So we just standing there waiting for the van to pick us up.
Okay, did a van come?
Yes, the van come. Only one van come.
Okay.
On the first batch.
Okay. Now, Bing, I want to ask you holistically and tell me objectively what you think. You survived this. In a way, the findings are not yet sure if it's pilot error, but Captain Andrews believes it is. But above and beyond the possible causes, were you satisfied with how the personnel handled all the passengers? Did you feel they knew what they were doing? Was someone in authority? Did you feel that?
Yes, I feel that the Cebu Pacific staff, especially the ground staff in Davao International Airport, they are very, very poor. It's been long time I always, they are not approachable to the people. And what they do always on the boarding, in the boarding counter, I'm not satisfied the way they do their services.
Okay, all right. As sabi ni Father Joel Tabora, no instructions were given. No calming words were spoken. Hindi daw kayo pinakalma. I'm curious, is this correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. All right. So what will be, siguro Candice, you can, this is your customer.
Yes, that's right. I think you heard it straight, no? From Lance himself, that he did say that he did apologize and for this unfortunate incident, no? And nobody wants this to happen. I think first and foremost, the priority was really to ensure that no one was hurt. So at least in that aspect, we are pleased that no one was hurt and that there was no injuries.
Mm-mm.
All right. Having said that, we do acknowledge that there are areas that we need to improve on.
Mm-mm. Okay,
especially on
training
the speed. Speed to response. Speed to respond to situations like this one. But understandably, I was also telling you earlier that the ground staff were also handling other flights that were supposed to depart that same evening.
Many flights were
there? Four. There were four other
in the
flights
airport
after this flight, right?
So, and that was taking off.
That was supposed to take off that same evening.
Did it take off?
No, the flights were canceled now because the runway was closed after this incident. So there was a lot that they were trying to do. It's not an excuse. We do acknowledge that we could have done better, but knowing that that was the situation, then we had immediately called for additional help from other stations aside from Davao, from the outstations, like from General Santos. We've asked for additional people to please, go to Davao to help us manage the situation. So we did the best we could at that given time. Mm-mm. But yes, there are learnings from what had happened, and we will, of course, learn and do better.
Okay. All right. Bing, I'm curious, where are you now? Are you in Davao?
I'm in Davao.
Okay, you live there, no?
No, I'm not really feel well. Just now, I can feel my body is just shaking.
Okay.
And I still on rest.
Okay. Now, what happens after a situation like this, Candice? Does everyone go through some kind of medical examination?
We are calling. We're trying to reach out to all the 165 passengers on that flight on 5J971. We've contacted half of the passengers by mobile.
Okay.
The other half we are unable to reach because maybe they were booked through agents or, we're calling their numbers. There's no response. So we've sent them emails already. We've also given them a special number to call 24/7. If they need medical assistance and they have gone and seen a doctor or if they bought medicine, all of that, we are going to reimburse them for their medical expenses.
Mm-mm.
If they are,
they can go to any doctor?
Yes.
Okay.
To have themselves checked, and we will reimburse them for their expenses. And we are, of course, providing for refunds or rebooking, depending on what they would like to do after this. So we are reaching out to them and we are calling them. And we've also sent them all emails with instructions on what special number to call and checking on how they are, actually.
Okay. All right. On that note, Bing, you heard what Candice said. Will you be taking a medical exam?
Yes, I'm going to do that this week.
Okay. All right. Miss Bing Harris, thank you so much for taking our call.
Okay.
Be safe and be well. We're going to take a quick break. When we return, we'll continue our conversation with CAAP Deputy Director General John Andrews and Cebu Pacific Vice President and Spokesperson Candice Iyog. Hot Copy, we'll be right back. All right, we're back on the show. We're talking about the Cebu Pacific crash in Davao City. Captain Andrews from CAAP would like to explain something you were saying, sir. Go ahead.
When an accident happens, we have the Aircraft Investigation Board coming into to do the official investigation.
Mm.
But correlated with this, the CAAP itself does its own investigation. Because there may be instances wherein we have to take immediate action to prevent similar accident from happening.
Okay.
This is what we have done today.
Okay. All right. So things that are new that we've taken from our discussion is, number one, CAAP has no authority to remove the plane unless the owner of the aircraft agrees.
That is correct.
Okay. Has the Lance Gokongwei agreed?
Well, we're still the ones doing it right now.
All right. So that's what we have now. So other reports that CAAP has started removing are false.
Yes, we gave the order, but it couldn't be done because the approval was not given.
Okay. So first, Cebu Pacific has to give the go signal. Number two, you believe in your own personal opinion that it is a pilot error.
Not on my personal opinion, but opinion of CAAP.
Okay, opinion
not
of
the AIB. AIB will just confirm later on. The mission of the AIB is to find out the facts and prevent a similar accident from happening.
Uh-oh.
Now, we investigate to be able to correct immediately if there are deficiencies. either in pilot training or whatever it may be.
So now you can already tell that there was nothing wrong with the plane, it was in good condition.
Yes.
Okay.
And this will be corroborated by the findings and the flight data recorder, which will be sent to Singapore for their...
Okay. All right. Now, number three is, of course, the question is, this is a $40 million plane. Cebu Pacific is even, not just to correlate with everything happening, is on an expansion mode. I mean, Cebu Pacific is buying new planes from Toulouse. Can you tell us about that before I go to my next question?
Yes, yes. We are actually, in fact, taking delivery of our very first A330 very soon.
Mm-mm.
It's scheduled for the end of next week.
Mm-mm.
So, yes.
Yeah, so, I mean, this is a tragedy considering that you were supposed to enter. I mean, there was some big news coming.
Yes,
media
that's
was
right.
going with you. I mean, you're taking home a new plane.
Yes, that's right, Karen. But I think we go back to the priority. We and put it in the context, the right context. No, first of all, we're just pleased that nobody was hurt.
Mm-mm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we know that there were. Some areas where we can improve, so we are working on that one as well, and the reaccommodation of the displaced passengers, and now the removal of the aircraft. So we have to focus on that. Once we have the formal, formal and the final report from the CAAP on the findings, then we can work from there.
Okay.
Because right now we don't have that information, and the photos that are being shown are actually new to us.
Okay. All right. Now, of course, while the safety of the passengers is the most important, Captain, can you show that photo again? And I want to ask you, can the $40 million plane be saved? Can it be used again? Can that be repaired? I mean, I just started to think the investments of these companies. I mean, pilot error can cost so much when it comes to lives, to the plane itself. Can that plane be saved and used again?
From the way it looks, I believe it will be beyond economical repair.
Honestly, okay. Yeah. Even if it's repaired abroad?
No, even if it's repaired abroad.
Mm-mm, mm-mm. Why is that? Can you share?
I believe that both engines have been damaged. There is going to be a question on the integrity of the airframe itself.
Okay.
Since there was a lot of stress induced in the aircraft. Since it was landing in unprepared surface, which was the right side of the runway. So a lot of stress was generated, and the airframe may no longer be usable.
Uh-uh. You were pointing at this a while ago. Can you show this direct? What is the significance of all this grass debris on the ground to the plane?
This grass debris was thrown by the engine.
Of the plane?
Of the engine of the plane as it was traversing
the... Pumasok siya sa engine, tapos lumabas.
It would enter the engine first and come out because they were on thrust reverse mode. That's why even the engines are very, very questionable now as far as their usage is concerned.
Because of what the engine took in?
That's right.
Okay.
Aside from the physical damage, there's physical damage to the engines.
I see. Okay. All right. Now, I want to read you this. This is coming from Coco Alcoaz's interview. He interviewed Lance last night on the phone. It would have been nice if we could have aired a longer part of the Lance interview. Okay, some facts, and you can go ahead and comment. Number one, Lance said, based on the inspection of the plane and the grounds, the Cebu Pacific plane appeared to have driven off rather than skidded off the runway and due to pilot error. Lance's evidence, Cebu Pacific plane landed safely 2 minutes earlier.
Yes.
Okay, fair. Number two, there was a crosswind that would have required the pilot to crab, that is, compensate by aiming into the wind. But Lance said the pilot should correct the plane the moment it hits the ground. He says the evidence shows the plane was never corrected and just drove off the runway in the same direction it was compensating for the crosswind rather than skidded off. My God, is Lance like an expert? Is that correct?
Those are the statements I made yesterday.
Okay.
He made.
You made it.
Okay.
Yeah. No. But Lance agreed to it.
No.
He didn't contradict it.
He didn't. I don't think he...
He didn't contradict. Coco said Lance did not contradict one and two.
Yes.
He didn't contradict, but I believe he said that at this point it's just too early to speculate as to what exactly had happened, and that we are waiting for the AIB and CAAP, of course, to give us the formal report, and then we can
okay.
look at that.
I'm going to ask you now number three, because Lance didn't, I don't, Coco wasn't able apparently to bring up number three and four. So we'll be verifying the flight recorder in Singapore?
In Singapore.
Yes. Yes,
okay.
Right.
All right. Something happened similar. Cebu Pacific flight to Puerto Princesa in 2011, details of which are part of a general review of CAAP. So this happened already to Cebu Pacific?
Yes, in the
Puerto Princesa 2011. Can you tell us about that?
The aircraft also landed under crosswind conditions.
Okay.
And of course, you have to head the aircraft towards the wind. The correction and landing was not done, so the aircraft continued on out of the runway.
Okay, but everybody survived.
Everybody
yes.
survived.
Yeah. Now, but see, Candice, my question is, if this has happened twice, I mean, in recent years, because the biggest challenge Cebu Pacific had ever experienced was the crash in...
87.
Cagayan de Oro. Yeah, Cagayan de Oro. I was already a reporter then. What year was this again? I think this
1999.
Yes, 1999. And, of course, Lance, there were many deaths. And Lance himself had gone to the site. Mm-hmm. So that was the biggest challenge for Cebu Pacific
that's
as
right.
a company.
Yes, that's right.
And Cebu Pacific had survived it and even flourished. But now, I think my question is, if this has happened twice, where the aircraft is in perfect condition, and then you have Puerto Princesa 2011 and now in Davao, doesn't this bring up, in other words, I'm saying, the skill of the pilots?
The reason why maybe that was not corrected is because this incident happened 2011. It was the findings were not finalized, nor was
yes,
it closed.
That's
yeah.
right.
We have only been reviewing this during our time, because there are a lot of accidents we have to review now, and we are now formalizing the actual report.
When you released the 2011 report, you mean it would have helped them?
Yes, it we would have had the corrective actions done then.
Okay.
But this was done before our time. Now, if you remember the Robredo crash.
Yes.
That was last August.
Yes.
After that crash, the president gave us marching orders that any incident or any accident involving anybody, the airline is automatically suspended.
Mm-mm. Okay. Do you recommend suspension for Cebu Pacific?
I don't think that would really be a nice thing to do now because of the commitments of Cebu Pacific.
Mm-mm.
But those are marching orders to the president. But if the president decides, based on the information we have now, it can be done.
Okay. You're saying it can be done to recommend? This is just major. I want to make sure. Are you recommending that Cebu Pacific be suspended?
Not at the moment.
Okay.
But these are the instructions of the president.
To what?
When there are accidents involving any airline, immediate suspension of their operations must be done.
Yeah, but...
Pending corrective action.
Yeah, we're talking about so many airlines. How many airlines does Cebu Pacific have?
No, how many airplanes?
Airplanes.
44. Yeah. That's why it's going to affect the nation.
Yes.
That is why we have to balance now the fact, are we going to recommend suspension or are we going to take immediate actions to correct?
Yeah, what do you think should you do?
I think we'd take the latter.
Okay, so not suspension, but take immediate actions to correct.
Yes.
Okay, Candice, you want to react?
I think, yes, we refer to an incident in Puerto Princesa in 2011, but as Captain Andrews did say and admit, the report hasn't been given to us. So in the same manner, it's difficult to actually say that it was the same incident because, again, we don't know exactly what happened.
All right.
And this incident, again, is still under investigation.
Now, from Twitter, we don't have enough time, but are you mentioning the name of the pilot? Is that allowed?
No.
Why
no.
not? Because people are asking right now, why aren't they mentioning the name of the pilot? Is this the first emergency incident by the pilot? Why aren't you mentioning the name of the pilot?
We keep the information confidential at the moment, although the pilot is grounded, so pending the results of the investigation.
So he's not flying?
No, he's not.
Okay. All right, last words. Go ahead, sir, quickly.
Well, we hope that we can prevent similar accidents from happening by taking the proper corrective actions. And we are going to initiate it immediately.
Mm-mm. Okay, Candice?
Yeah. We're very happy that nobody got hurt. Second, our priority right now is to remove the aircraft, and secondly is to reaccommodate all the displaced passengers because of the cancelled flights. Mm-mm. So for those who have flights today, we are sending them emails and trying to get in touch with them. But if you have a flight today, please call the call center at 7020888.
7020888. At
may sasagot, ha? Yes, yes, of course. That's our call center. And so that we can give them their options. If they want to rebook it to a later flight, if they want to rebook it when the airport opens, if they want to fly from General Santos, we will provide the transfers. And if they wish to refund it, we will. Mm. We will.
You will return it in
yes,
cash.
Yes, okay. Yes. Okay. If they paid in cash, of course.
All right.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. On that note, Candice, thank you so much for coming, Captain Andrews. Thank you for the information you shared. It was very valuable. Thank you. That's Head Start today. I'm